Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, front-wheel drive cars and handling. The biggest bang for your buck, the most wonderful thing you can do to your front-wheel drive car and mine is add one thing, a rear sway bar. For a front-wheel drive car to handle well, you want to kind of upset the back of the car and make the back grip less. Aftermarket companies make a sway bar for my old 2010 Hyundai, but they make them out of 5/8 steel bar. I don't have any 5/8, but I do have 3/4, so I fabricated this 3/4-inch rear bar, which I attached on the back of the car, and it made it okay. This is, mathematically, 100% stiffer than the sway bars you can buy. 100% more stiffer than the aftermarket bars. So, interesting. Now, I drove it like this for a while and it was okay. However, I want more cowbell. So, this is 7/8 steel. It is also 100% stiffer than the bar I just made. So this is 200% stiffer than the aftermarket bars you can buy. And it was fun. It was pretty cool. This was like, I like this. This is okay. But I want more. So this is what I did. I sat down with Fusion 360 and I started drawing up the designs of how I wanted it to look. This is the first time I've tried to design parts that key together. So that was kind of an interesting experience. And since I seem to be making a fair number of sway bars for this Hyundai Accent, I might as well make this easier on myself. So we're going to give this one a go. So we plunk her down on the plasma cutter and we'll let her do her business. This is a Bailey 2x2. Doesn't take up a whole lot of space. It can use an ordinary handheld plasma cutter like most do. And I think we're using an old Hobart plasma cutter machine on this device. Then sandblast. It's all nice and neat. Nice and neat and pretty. And then we're going to TIG weld the whole thing together. So it's all pretty. You could probably MIG it. Some of you would probably want to stick weld it. I prefer TIG, so that's what I'm going to do. Interestingly, I did not have my reading glass cheater lens in my helmet, so I had to hold my head up a bit so I could look through the bottom of my progressive old man lenses, and consequently sunburned my neck. So, kids out there, make sure there's no exposed skin while you're welding. No, you cannot weld naked. Sorry. And kind of fun welding it all together. For some crazy reason, I went through a lot of tungsten because I just kept touching. Oh my gosh. And there we go. Two brackets that'll go like... And you guys saw me do this and you said nothing. Back to the plasma cutter. All right, there. Two lefts, two rights. Now I got to make two sway bars. Okay, all right, carrying on. So I picked up a piece of 3/4-inch Schedule 40 pipe, used, or at least it always seems to be rusty, and that got old pretty quick. Then I got a genius idea, and I spun this up on the lathe with my grinder. Don't worry, I'm showering the sparks somewhere else. I tried a file, but, you know, if you just slow down and speed up, it worked okay. Never wear gloves while using machinery. Don't do this. I was impulsive. Impulsivity is how we get injuries. But this did a really good job of getting it all nice and shiny, and it worked really slick. Don't wear gloves. There we are. Blasted again, and I drilled more holes because I measured wrong, and it didn't bolt up, and I had to re-drill. I had to drill more holes in the in-between adjustability, and then I had to set up a boring bar because it was bigger than half-inch holes but smaller than 9/16, and it just kicked my butt. So I got to use a little boring bar on the milling machine, not shown because there was words. I've since changed my CAD design, my Fusion design, so this will be okay. You want to have the holes spaced at least 0.566 times 3. Which would be the two holes that you're going to be putting bolts through are 1.698 inches apart. So that's what you're going to want to do. I made a jig out of some 2x2 just because I figure I'm probably going to be making more of these as I experiment and try different sizes. So that worked, and that thing worked absolutely slick. They went right back on the car super nice. There's a whack of little drain holes
in the spring pockets of the back axle that I just dropped a couple half-inch bolts in. You don't even really need to use a wrench. And it holds the whole thing together pretty slick, pretty easy. So, fully TIGged. I hope these arms are rigid enough. I've changed my design a little bit. I'll show you a picture of the the next version if I get that far a little bit later. Epoxy primer, let it set up overnight, and then I sprayed some red paint. The primer is Proform. I used a lot of that on my 61 Chevy pickup. And the paint is Shopline from Lord Co. I don't know who makes Shopline. Might be PPG. Who knows? And it's just the same color red for the fenders of my Super 7. Just because I happen to have it. Turned out the hardener had expired, so it took all day for this to cure. But I'm sure it'll work. It'll be fine. Two coats, actually three coats, a dust on a tack coat, and then two wet coats. I think I'm just showing you one. And then I set it in the sun to help expedite the curing process. I need to get some fresh hardener.
So this is the latest version, CNC cut ends and arms on it like this. This is now a 3/4 inch schedule 40 pipe. Bigger in diameter, but it's hollow. This is actually lighter than the 7/8 bar, but mathematically it should be 30% stiffer than the 7/8 bar. And this hopefully will be kind of nice. Failing that, this is a fart bigger than 1 inch. I made another set of arms, and if I need even more, I can build one with a solid 1 inch bar, and that will be 30% stiffer than this one, or 70% stiffer than the 7/8 bar. Have I lost you on the math yet?
So the aftermarket bar and my first 3/4 inch design, I would call your stage one. So this would be your stage one sway bar. I wouldn't go smaller than 3/4. 7/8 would be your stage two. And then this guy, this is the drunk bar. It's going to be awesome. Then we'll get this thing installed. I just have it on some, I don't know what these are called. Found them on Grassroots Motorsport. Some simple design. I'm sure there's a name for it. Wheel cribbing, who knows? But it just gave me a way to have the thing up in the air with the wheels sitting, hanging properly so I can put the bar on and off easily. And my impact fits underneath it. Then we'll take it for a rip, see how it goes.
So I autocrossed it, and so my math is actually a little screwy. Previously I mentioned it's like 30% stiffer than the bar I had before. Mathematically, I don't know what I did. I was drunk when I did the numbers, but it should be 93% stiffer. But it felt about 20% stiffer. It was, but not like epic. And I think that the reason is these arms. I think because the bar isn't held in the middle like a typical sway bar, it's only held at the ends and it's trying to resist the torsional beaming from beaming torsionally. I think this is possibly the issue where these are flexing, and I may get under there and measure it, jacking up one side and seeing if there's some twist in these. So, before I run out and make a bigger diameter bar, I'm going to make another bar and print out, plasma cut another set of ends, and then just use 3/4 schedule 40 for a bar and 3/4 schedule 40 for an arm, because that arm going this way is going to be a lot more rigid torsionally than a flat piece of metal. So we'll see if that brings some of the strength back, and I'll report back to you if it's epic. If it isn't epic, there's going to be a video of me making another sway bar, probably bigger. So that's it for now. We're going to see. I'm going to make sway bar number 4, and we'll try that one out. We do have an autocross coming up in a couple weeks. Hopefully I'll have it ready for that, and we'll give you some feedback. As always, thanks for watching. Take care, and we'll see you again.